cells are the basic unit of life. And so in order to understand human disease, we need to understand ourselves. And the surprising problem is that despite spending, you know, a good couple of centuries on this problem, scientists still don't know all of our cells. The Human Cell Atlas is an international initiative of scientists whose goal is to map the cells of the human body, to understand all of their properties and use this map as a foundation to understand human health and disease. We want to know the different kinds of cells that are there. Then we want to know how these different cells are organized next to each other, who is talking to whom and what are they doing. And then we want to understand how they change over time. The first draft of the Human Cell Atlas will probably include about 100 million cells. They will span maybe 12 major organs and systems. They would have individuals of both genders. It would have some geographical diversity. And it would tell us probably a lot for those organs about the complete census of cells in them and about their relative organization.
As genome biologists, it became possible to sequence the nucleic acid content of single cells. So that's single cell genomics technology. That was one of the things that I think sparked a lot of people's imagination around the world, and where we said, okay, we can now map cells in a comprehensive way, you know, one by one, essentially.
In this exciting discovery, we found not only that there is a cell type in our lung and airways we didn't even know existed, but we discovered that this is the cell type that actually expresses the gene that encodes CFTR, which is the protein that is damaged in patients with cystic fibrosis.
Pediatric kidney cancers, it turned out to be a cell type that arises during development. So it's actually saying that the tumor probably arises in utero, so in the uterus. And for the adult cancers, we were able to pinpoint many different cell types that different classes of renal cell carcinomas belong to.
The goal of the Human Cell Atlas is to provide a reference map in order to understand, diagnose, and treat human health and disease. I've always been fascinated by cells, and in particular in understanding how cells actually work, what are the programs that make them go, and the Atlas of Cells will give us an unprecedented opportunity to recover those programs and understand how to make this remarkable thing called the cell actually work to our desires.